Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to the Communist Mall. This is Hearts of Iron 4. I'm Orbit of Potato. We're playing as Paraguay. And, this is a fairly bad state of affairs, if I'm completely honest. I think that we really just need to not give up, but we need to be prepared to take some pretty heavy losses. Do we care about any of this stuff? Not really. Do I care about any of this stuff? I don't care about tank designer, chief of navy, chief of air force, military high demand. No. I mean, maybe, yeah, we'll get that. That might help us out just a smidgen in the mountains. But honestly, I'm doubtful. This is going to be very, very difficult to fix. The country that we were cooing, that kind of failed. I'll be honest, it kind of failed. I think even if we managed to make it so that there would be... Let's go there and then into there. Even if we could make it so that two coups popped at the same time, even if we could do that, I think it's still unlikely that we would ever make some sort of a breakthrough. And I don't know, I feel that there is no way in my eyes to do a sort of more diplomatic route. I simply don't think there is. I really don't think there is. We have been failing very, very hard in trying to do a diplomatic route, and I don't think that has been down to my decisions, quite frankly. I really don't. I really, really do not. I think that we have, for the most part, done a pretty darn good job of managing diplomacy and everything like that, but we can't. Maybe it's in part due to the country that we chose to, you know, start things off. But at the same time, I don't know. I think that it's diplomacy, and I've looked into a couple of mods that that we could use to fix the whole terrible diplomacy situation. Just stay here. I think that's good enough. Armor effort, that sounds good to me. National focus, special. Yeah, let's get special forces. Yeah, why not? Do it. Do it, do it, do it. So as you can see, this coup attempt. Yep. Yep, there we go. That failed pretty darn dramatically. And now we are still at war with Paraguay. Not Paraguay. We are Paraguay. We're still at war with Uruguay and Argentina. A battle which I am afraid will probably end with the destruction of the country. You know what? Am I concerned? Am I heck? Am I heck? We did just get 5 new troops though, didn't we? Yeah. These new bad boys. Let's just get you guys entrenched. Honestly, there could be some sort of a comeback. There really could be, right? There really could be. But I am not very hopeful, I'll be honest. Iran joined the Axis. Soviet Union declared war on Iran. That's fine, I guess. If you want to do that. Yeah, let's make an offensive line. Can we not? Excuse me? Okay, there we go. That's pretty much what I wanted. Well, ideally I'd like to edit that a little bit. That's not really what I wanted at all. Can you just work for me, please? So, that's, again, not what I wanted, but okay, I guess that'll do. That'll have to do. What is this? The superior enemy, large river crossing, division still preparing. Yeah, I thought so. Now, it would be ideal if we had some, you know, paratroopers that we could paratroop into somewhere. And you know what? We bloody well could try it. We could go for like a last ditch attempt where we Turkey has capitulated. Jeez Louise. Was that by the did the Soviet Union make Turkey capitulate? Iran. Yeah, holy cow, the Soviet Union did actually do a good job on taking Turkey. That's strange. That's very, very strange how they're doing so well down there, yet they're not even managing to capture their capital. Quite frankly, I think that if the German Reich arrives at Moscow and is unstoppable, then I think that we're probably just going to end the series, because there's not much that I can do if my biggest bud, the Soviet Union, is out of the game. which is, you know, it was kind of the plan, you know, to team up with the Soviet Union. But that has proven to be rather challenging, I think is probably the correct term. Yeah, I'll take you. Thank you. Yeah, are we under attack? I don't think we're under attack. Let's get a new general. New commander? Sure. Wow, you guys look totally different. Congratulations. Welcome along. Let's give you a front line. Your front line can be okay all along there, I guess. It's quite a big front line to deal with, but I guess we're gonna have to do it. It's gonna be slightly challenging. These guys look exactly the same. How on earth are we supposed to know the difference? I mean, look, at the end of the day, we've gained one single square of territory. And that, in my eyes, is a rip-roaring success. A rip-roaring success. We've got no industry that we can really fall back on, which kind of sucks a little bit, unfortunately. But that's fine. At war with Uruguay, at war with Argentina, and things are not going in our favor. Yes. We contributed 85% of the war effort. 85% of the war effort, and I've contributed basically nothing to this war. Like, I think that should really show how much I've actually done. You, okay, let's get you to engage. Yeah, you know, fuck it. I'm gonna try and take a piece of land. This could be the comeback that we've all been waiting for. 8 days. We might actually win that one if we continually siege it like this. Okay, it's gone up, but it's coming back down. I just don't know if we've got the breakthrough potential with the paratroopers. Like, they're not supposed to be fighting on the ground. Like, we were supposed to be airdropping into Uruguay right now, but I took the opportunity to go to war with Argentina, and maybe it was the worst decision that I ever made. I mean, I knew it wasn't the worst decision I ever made. I'm sure I've made worse decisions in my life, but, you know, maybe that just was not the right call for what was required. Who knows? We might actually legitimately take a piece of land. That would be astounding if we did that. Factory repair speed? Don't really care about that, to be honest. Maybe resource efficiency gain? I guess that's kind of what we want. Wow, holy cow. This is actually... Wow! Gee, we got it! That was across a river crossing as well. I mean, we are still on zero manpower, which is hugely problematic. And we are going to adjust that pretty darn soon, actually. We're going to change our policy. In fact, it might be worth just going into recruiting and deploying. I'm going to say you get deployed instantly. And you cancel production so that we've got a little bit of manpower just to distribute, which immediately gets sucked up, but hey-ho. Anyway, let me just have a little check on the Soviet Union and see how they're doing in defending the attacks from Germany. Invite to a faction. Ask to join faction. Can I ask to join their faction? Is that something that I can do? I don't want to justify a war goal against them. I don't know if we can ask to join their faction. Invite to faction? No. I don't know. Funny. Okay, we need to go back to Argentina, and we need to continue to boost the party popularity, and we'll try and stage a coup sometime, I guess. Because we can't offer peace with Uruguay or with Argentina, so hey, sounds great. Okay. So, currently there is a little hole in our lineup there, but that's okay. That shouldn't be too difficult to do. Now, there is a river crossing. There's a river running all the way under here. There's not a river running over here, though, so we might be able to take this area if we're lucky. I mean, we've got a few troops that might be able to do the job, but I am rather doubtful. The good news is, though, is that there is a river running here, which means that this tile is effectively unsiegeable. And this tile, if we could get it, would be unsiegeable, too. Is it worth, is, you know what, is it worth just combining armies? Because we no longer need an army for just paratroopers. Yeah, let's actually just unassign everyone and equip them all to this guy here. And it is gonna kind of suck to combine. No, yeah, just do it to there. It's gonna kind of suck to do that, but hey ho, it's gonna be fine. Okay, United States stands against fascism. It kind of sucks, but whatever, I guess. Well, it's kind of good, I guess. Whoa, are you moving into here? What? Why did? What the fuck? How long are you gonna take to arrive? 9 days! And you're gonna arrive in 4 days. What the fuck? What the actual fuck? What happened? Why did people move out of there? Jesus Christ, what the fuck was you? Oh my God. Jesus Christ. Well, that's that piece of territory lost, which is very, very sucky. Very, very sucky indeed. Okay, yeah, so we're having a little bit of a redistribute around here. Honestly, I think that that's probably for the better. We kind of need it. We need to make sure that this territory doesn't get captured. Like, I have no idea why we've suddenly abandoned this area, considering we had all the troops over here. I'm just gonna blame the AI, right? That seems like a completely legitimate thing to do. Special forces, great. Cast effort, I guess. Kind of worth it. More factories than 50. We've got 12 factories. That 50 number is a long, long way away. All right, let's try and capture this area, actually. I'm actually kind of hopeful. Let's give it a shot. Let's give it a shot. Let's go on the offensive here. I think this is the right time to be doing it. Although we have zero manpower. We need 150 political power to be able to do anything. 6 days that's gonna last for. Yeah, you're gonna be moving. How long is it gonna take? Oh my God. Why on earth? How did we have so many people over here and then suddenly everybody's here? Like, I don't understand how it happened. Doesn't make sense to me. Also, why is this war no longer going on? We're gonna lose this. We're gonna lose this territory. Fucking great. Just fucking great. Everybody takes such a fucking long time to get around. Our infrastructure is fucking awful. It's bloody, bloody awful. Oh, come on. Yeah, our infrastructure is truly horrific. Why are we not attacking into here? Okay, because we're gonna lose, that's why. I don't want to retreat there, I want to move in there. Yeah, I think that we're having some pretty serious issues right now. In all honesty. Pretty severe, pretty difficult to deal with. How was this captured? How was that captured? How was this captured? I have zero idea. Literally zero idea. All right, infantry equipment, let's put as many factories on as possible. Four factories, let's get rid of you. I don't care about canceling the production line. I only care about getting these guys with the best military equipment possible. As soon as we have 150 political power, we're gonna straight away start pumping out some new stuff, which is gonna be really exciting. It's gonna potentially work. There we go, get that, I guess. Okay, yeah, this is not looking so great, I'll be honest. This is not looking so great. It's pretty dodgy. In all honesty, I think that the reason that we haven't lost is more down to Argentina's incompetence rather than my expert leadership strategies, you know what I'm saying? We are going to win this battle, which is rather nice, but it's only because we're defending. Yeah. Doesn't make me feel great about myself, I'll be honest. if the only battles that we can actually win are the ones that we are defending. So, Argentina now. So wait, could we try for like some super sneaky bullshit? Like this might not work, right? But also, where the hell have all my paratrooper divisions gone? Have they just disappeared? Do we have one paratrooper division left? Is that it? Jesus Christ, what is our manpower must be fucking abysmal. Alright, we need to get to the airport. We need to plan a paratrooper order from here. Needs to go down all the way to here. Confirm location. There we go. For one guy, that's all we need. We're gonna try this because our paratrooper division is very, very, very... current fighting strength, 14%. Yep, not enough manpower. Not enough manpower to reinforce. Not enough manpower to do a damned thing. Extensive conscription, limited conscription, service by requirement. That's what we're gonna do. It's gonna give us a little bit of extra manpower. No divisions in basic training. I should hope not. This is gonna give us a little bit of an extra life, but unfortunately, I think we've lost half the country. We're gonna start losing resources as well, which is really sucky. Okay, engage the battle plan. Engage the battle plan. We dropped. Oh god. We're surrounded by troops. Make a quick beeline for Buenos Aires. Okay. This is not gonna go well. Like, this is bound to fail. We did manage to capture it, though, which is actually rather impressive and is a significant step up from what we previously did. Yep, you're suffering attrition, and now we're battling into the enemies. Which, we might win, but it's a suicide mission, quite frankly. It's a suicide mission. Yeah. It's a suicide mission. And I think that there's a couple of things that went wrong during this campaign. And one of them was, or is, the fact that that the ability to control the, diplomatically, it's very, very difficult to do. And it's a real, real, real pain in the ass. Let's just retreat everybody up here and let them crush us. Diplomatically, this game is very, very weak, I feel, and there's not many options apart from cooing, and even cooing does fuck all. Like, 50% of the population is communist, and the country erupts into, like, a pathetic civil war. I think that kind of sucks. Another thing that we were sort of, you know, caught off guard with is that, you know, we had prepared for a sneaky paratrooper war against Uruguay, and it didn't work. It didn't work. It didn't work at all. It did not work at all. There we go. Let's disband everybody so that we can let ourselves be crushed. Again, probably not a great country to pick, in all honesty. Paraguay, very, very weak, I think, in South America. But it was a really, really good, fun attempt. I really enjoyed it. Paraguay has capitulated. Well, you did a good job. Holy shit. Holy shit. Wow. We actually exist as a democratic state now. Yeah. Not surprised. We've got our own force. We've got a little bit of manpower. Wow, and we've been invited to a faction. Honestly, I would love to accept, but the communist mole is dead. The dream is dead. I'm not sure what other series we're going to be doing in Hearts of Iron. I want to get some mods installed because I really feel that diplomatically this game is very, very weak, and it needs a heck of a lot more work in that department. So I'm looking forward to seeing if we can trick it out with some cool stuff that'll perhaps change the game in a way. It doesn't change it hugely, but at least makes it a little bit different. And a little bit interesting in some other ways. So, ladies and gents, thank you very, very much for watching this series. Apologies, it was a big gamble that we took, and you know what? It didn't pay off. But in other times, I'm sure that it would have paid off. If you want to give it a shot, I would recommend that you do it. The Soviet Union is about to fall. Like, let's be completely honest. There is not a chance in hell that what? Lithuania? What? What are you doing? Oh no, it's France that's taken over Germany. Yeah, no, it seems that Moscow is going to fall. It's going to fall pretty darn soon. So there wasn't much hope. The Soviet Union always seems to be very, very weak in the games that I have played in. A little bit strange, but hey ho. Super, super, super fun game. Really enjoyed it. Really good to fiddle around with diplomacy. And I look forward to playing Hearts of Iron 4 again in the very, very near future. So, ladies and gents, thank you very, very much for watching. My name, of course, has been Orbit of Potato. This has been the Communist Mole Hearts of Iron 4, and I'll see you next time. Bye!